So good morning guys, today's topic is optical square. We are using this optical square to measure the straightness or flatness of the surface. So let's say what is optical square. Optical square is a pentagonal prism. Okay, you can see here optical square is a pentagonal prism. Okay, optical square is based on double reflection. You can see the ray will come here one time reflected, and after that from this mirror to again reflected, so two times reflection. And optical square is used for turning the light on the line of the of sight by 90 degree from its original path. So you can see here, from here light is coming, from here is light is coming. So first reflection is in there, it's going to here to here. So the projection line or reflection line will be 90 degree from the original path. It is the original path and the reflection is the degree from the 90 degree from the original path. Okay, it's used in pairs in surveying and singular block. So we are using for surveying and the singular block, or some in our metrology lab we are going through the complicated measuring the straightness of the complicated areas. Okay, so uses of optical square. What is the uses of optical square? The axis of incident beam from the autocollimator from the measuring datum. Okay, and optical square is utilized for turning the indicated beam through the exactly 90 degree. This is the main important topic. Okay, main important point. Okay, in this test it's assumed that two surfaces are perfectly straight, stainless steel mirror blocked with flat A base used for the horizontal surface and aligning the collimator, and that autocollimator we are saving here we are using that the autocollimator with the surface of A reading is thus taking autocollimator position A by B. We'll discuss what will happen. This is the autocollimator reflected line, here the plane reflector, and here the we can see the optical square. So we are going to measure that B portion surface straightness or flatness. Okay, so this is the surface one. This is the surface 2. We are going to measure this portion only. Okay, the mirror base is transferred to the vertical surface and optical square placed in the angle integrated. Now the difference between two reading would be a squareness error. Okay, difference between the two readings would be the squareness error. Okay, we can measure this flatness, and we can also measure the differences between two measurement. Okay, with one is with optical square and one is without optical square. Okay, so another thing is optical flat. What is optical flat? It's nothing. Optical flat is cylindrical. Previous one, that optical square is in pentagonal, and this optical flat is cylindrical in form with working flat surface. And optical flat may be on any transparent material, usually glass with highly polished surface. The surface is highly polished. Okay, optical flat are made with fused quartz and borosilicate glass. This glass are clear and colorless. Okay, we have to need the colorless glass. The cylindrical square of the optical flat is finished by the grinding and the working surface of the lapping and polishing. We already study about the lapping and polishing and manufacturing process. So by through of this machining process, we are going to prepare or produce the optical flat. Here you can see some optical flat product. This is the clearance glass we are talking about. So this glass we will put on the surface which we have to measure. Okay, uses of optical flat. The flatness of the working surface of an optical flat is tested by comparing the flatness with the master flat, is known as flatness. Okay, the testing is usually carried out by the observing of the interface fringe using the monochromatic light. So always we have to use the monochromatic light source. Okay, if the optical flat and that test has perfectly flat surface, then the fringe observed will be straight line. I will show you if the flatness is the surface is perfectly truly flat, that time how much that time what's the shape will come, or what's the pattern will come. I will show you. So here you can see this is the surface and this is the optical flat. We are using the monochromatic light source. These are the monochromatic light source which one have only one ray. Okay, if the flat if the surface is flat, that time what will happen? Surface is flat, that time only straight line will come. If this if the surface have some curve or some bending area, that time it will show this type of pattern. If it's have some different kind of or irregularities of surface or the flatness area, that time it will show this type of flatness. So here we can easily use we can easily recognize which surface is flat and which surface is not flat. Okay, hope you guys understand. Okay, thank you.